that I need to speak on the microphone, and please, everyone should do this because it's recorded. We'll start now with three presentations, one from Lithuania, one from Serbia, one from Japan. And the session will take around 1 hour and 45 minutes. 1 hour will be almost the presentations, and then we'll follow with three groups discussion. So it's not going to be question answer, it will be a three groups discussion after the presentation. Okay. Between 10 to 15. Okay. There's no rush, but we will try to make it a fast session and not very fast. And now we'll start with our colleagues from Serbia.
Using the Serbian DNA project, we first get the result of Mirich family, which we can find search on searching board of the Serbian DNA project. We research for these surnames by entering the surname, the place of origin of the family, and something what is characteristic for Serbian population. We added the family's Saint Patron in Serbian called Krsna Slavina. Now, when we click search, we get the result, and we can see that the Mirich family belong to haplogroup G2JM205. On the map, we see that the family is located in the today's Montenegro. And now we research the same parameters in the digital library. We enter the surname, the family Saint Patron, and the place of origin of the family. This is the result of the research in the library, and now we see the results in the found book. In this result, we can see that the family is bounded by the all parameters that we entered. And according to that, we see that the family is from the village called Vodjeni, which is the same name as the one brotherhood in him that existed in the history, also called Vodjeni. I will also say that by the Mirich family, also Pejanović family was tested. The Pejanović family also had the tradition in from the place of Vojvodina, and the same Saint Patron family. Like the Mirichs. According to that, we could create a genetic brotherhood of the Vojvodina, and after that, the third family that was tested was the family Klinčković. It was the Klinčković had the tradition being from the Dugo Selo in today's Croatia, and when we search more about Klinčković, we could see that there were no Klinčković family in the Dugo Selo, but in the Dugo Selo place there was a family Klinčković, which showed us that there could be the possibility of that the Klinčković family was a variation of Klinčković surname. So this brings us to the conclusion that the Klinčković, that the family Klinčković was from the Klinčković family, and the Klinčković family alludes us to the clan of Klinč. So the Klinčković are the descendants of Klinči clan. And in the end, so we according to these three tested families, could conclude that the, and some others also with the family surname which begins with term Klinč, that the all of them probably belong to the Klinč clan. After the testing of others belonging to the JM205 haplogroup, we until today we can see that there was found for about 200 persons tested in Serbian DNA project that belong to the Klinč clan. that would be all. Okay, so questions?
If you have any questions, we will have a discussion, so you can ask the question to the presenter or the forum table. You can ask him. I think it's a very interesting project and I have many questions.
Okay.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Each has a better data correction. in terms of abolition of rape. The next day, the alligators, yeah, in Japan, so many alligators in the Japan on the universities, the national levels, and cultural heritage, and all places in the museums, and public private companies. Another one, the regional digital archives. It's each of the prefecture library and the prefecture museums who work with the regional levels archives. Next one. The top level is the national library. National library is gathering all the metadata, harvesting, automatically harvesting from the public libraries and university libraries. And the national, and we are going to the national diet libraries. The national diet library, this is the national library, it's the largest portal in Japan. Two or three years before, the Japanese government has been decided new, more largest portal, not only to the library, the museums and the archives and the broadcastings, all included to the Japan Search. Japan Search is all of the cultural organization, including the large portal. Now, just starting from this year, the very new one. Now the Japan Search paper, the trial version, was starting open to public. This is a new direction in Japan. I was compared to the NDA Search and Japan Search, how to do what kind of the difference are here, and how we are focusing to the searching to the local history materials. Now, this is a schematic of the Japan Search method now to many organizations accumulated to the metadata, harvesting metadata can be retrieved. The all the document and the videos and others. Now, this blue colors part is not included to the very unique organization contents. The NDA Search not included this kind of organization. One, for example, Japan Broadcasting Corporation is broadcasting in Japan, the largest broadcasting company. There's so many TV programs and others. They can enter from this site. Now, this is the relationship between NDA and Japan Search paper. Nowadays, Japan Search paper is smaller than NDA Search. They are more comprehensive nowadays. I will show to exactly. This is the local history sources in Japan on NDA Search and Japan Search paper. Comparative studies has been done to this one. In Japan, two Chinese letters used for the local history. This is a more historical Chinese letter used in Japan. This is more modern, same as China. Survey on the NDA Search and Japan Search compared to nowadays, the total number of people is very higher than the Japan Search. The NDA Search is very more comprehensive. Many data, metadata, gathered to many places. And this is only to data materials. This number of the report including to the printed books, printed materials. This is only to the data materials. This is also The reason why there is such a problem was on Japan search. Nowadays, when there are such so many aggregating of these aggregators of the data collection and also harvesting to the data. Very big reason. This is a more detailed survey to the MDA sites. There are two Chinese letters in the meaning in the local history. But same as Brent has been shown to this Chinese letter is a historical Chinese letter. In Japan, very long years used with these letters. The total number is higher than here to get a new one. And also, the most of the part of the 50% of the 77% of the group oriented. And data materials is 30% of the 29%. Nearly same as around 30% of the digital materials. Original group is all of the pages digitalized can be seen. This is nearly 30%. And this is more details. The one of the big reasons to the public library catalog. All of the public libraries metadata harvesting in the case of the DL. Each of the each public library local collection, local history collection, also harvesting to the metadata. That is a very big part of the 25, and this is all types of characters, around 60% of the public libraries catalogs. Okay, next one. Now, these are briefly introduced to the aggregators in Japan. First one is university libraries relating to any type of data collection. The National Institute, not libraries. Harvesting to the this is the Institute of Repository Databases, the National Basic Databases. It's a large, one of the largest aggregators in Japan. And second one, the cultural database online. This is a very unique type of the aggregators. All of the museums. Data harvesting to the metadata harvesting to the this is a original creating to the original pages and others based on the museums. This is a very unique one. Okay. The third one is a cardiac is a this is a very unique aggregator for the open history resources. The companies operating to this system. But here is 2 years before, I have present the satellite meeting in the local districts in Lithuania. But this system, many times of the local district in the public libraries, museums, aggregators, directly. After this is regional aggregators, each of the road regions, prefecture levels, aggregators, there are so many. And this is the most part of Japan's local history is very different. The most part of Japan, Hokkaido Island is the one of the region, the part of Japan is a big. very unique to the library, museums, art museums, and art, and archaeological centers, any type of centers, metadata artists, so can be built with this. Another one is this is the south part of the Sinai, the Okayama collection. This is also local history material, so many gathered to many kinds of library and other resource centers. And the last one is different approaches to the communication. This is the local history resources. University libraries have local history materials. And these are books and others digitalized. Both on the site, using the audio system used to this case. This case is audio using to the, this case can be retrieved from the NDL search. NDL search is very big portal. Everybody access to that case can be researched for each of the universities. In the future, we have done what kind of things more important, most important things. This is a clear search of the first search part to do with that in the future. It's very important. Nowadays, the most prefectural library provides search of data collection on the website. All of them not included in these two large portals. The university libraries also same up. All of the data collection not included to these two portals. In the future, the more harvesting the metadata is very important. Nowadays, NDA search is not enlarged. In large number of the libraries and indicators, which surprised the data recently. But in the future, to how to more expand the Japan search. Japan search is more, not only to the library area, more expanded to the museum and the broadcasting companies and others. It's very important in the future. Especially to the coverage of local history resources in Japan, such is more expanded. It's very important. I have mentioned nowadays very roughly to calculate about 30% of the local historical materials already digitalized can be retrieved in Japan. But other 70%, other side, 70% not yet digitalized. But more resources, not only, nowadays only to access to the paper material. In the future, more local historical resources, how to digitalize and very important targeting. Thank you.
Okay, now we have
together next week.
Where I'm living. and what we done with these tapes. We collected its collections of people who gave us these video films, and all our visitors, all people who are interested in this, can find this information on our website, and they can read about it, what are about these videotapes are. And also we brought it from these old videotapes to new, to CDs, and people who want, they can come to the library. We have a small cinema at the library, and people can watch these CDs and these video information. And also they can borrow to schools, they can borrow to home and watch this information. And I want to show you what's possible. Just will tell you that we, as I said, we write these videotapes to CDs, and what we wanted to do more, that they wouldn't just be at the library, but we could use them in educational activities and show to the young generation and people who are interested in this. So we have an educational activity which is called a program which is called Get to Know the History of Shirvay City in a Different Way. Why it's different way? That because usually people learn history from books, but in this case you can learn from video films, and also we invite people who told us this or gave us VCDs, web participants of some history events, that they would also participate in these educational activities. So people, young people especially, can ask them what they experienced, how did they feel, and many other questions. So there is like a communication between different generations. And here are some examples from these videos. Of course, they are old, not like nowadays, not so colorful, but here you can see like different history moments from Shirvay life, from the city, or from, there's also movies about some people, local people, and after that, because we know that young people usually they listen, but they don't really hear a lot. So what we want, we invite them to play a game, a
and we invite them to play Kahoot quiz. Maybe you know it. Yes, and a lot of like children, especially, they are so excited when they see that they are going to play this game because they play Kahoot also at schools and at homes, and they know this program very well. So they are excited, and we invite them to answer the questions about what they saw in the movies, in the documentaries, and we hope that in this way, at least some information will stay with them, and it will be easier for them to remember some dates, some people, some history facts, and it will help them at school. And what we are hoping to do in the future, we are hoping that we can use this information which we already collected even more, and we can to digitalize these videotapes even more and upload to LIPIS system. It's what we call it's a bibliographic system linking information about documents stored in Lithuanian libraries, like printed matter, films, videotapes, audio cassettes, electronic documents, and etc. So libraries keep many information here that people could come to this website and find what they need. What else we are going to add some collections of video films about history of Šiaulių city to the largest Lithuanian digitalization library ePaveldas, and also to the website Europeam, that all people in Europe could find this information if they need. And also I will tell you very shortly about another project which we had with Professor Patrick from the United States. He was professor at a local university for a few years and lived in the country. And he was very interested in one of historical moment in which happened in Šiauliai. And because he was speaking some Lithuanian, but it's difficult for him to speak our language, we had this cooperation between library and between professor. So it's a drama festival which is called Atgaiva. And it happened almost more than 30 years ago now. So on that time, Lithuania still was in Soviet Union, but we already wanted to be independent. This drama festival, some people think, and also Professor Patrick also thinking that this festival was like encouraging to get freedom again, and many people came to this festival and participated, and the main purpose of this festival was not only to encourage Lithuanian theaters to build the best Lithuanian classics as well as contemporary dramaturgy activities. But also it was important because it was like creating a democratic atmosphere in Lithuania. And what was done? Because there was no information, just a few old papers who wrote about this festival and many people who participated in this festival. So the library and professor invited people to come and to give interviews, to talk about the experience in this festival, to talk what was happening, how they realized after couple decades, what was the importance of this festival. So 9 people came here, and we have 9 interviews, and you can find these interviews on our website. They are translated also into English, so all people can, most people can reach for them. And here is an example of one interview with drama theater director. So all information is here, and we hope that people who are interested in this festival can search for information and find it on our website. So as I said in the beginning, it's very important that local people would share the videotapes, the memories with people. And in our case, our library took this role of trying to collect information, and I hope that it's very that for community, it's for future generations, we will have collected important information, and anyone who needs can find it on our website or on at our library. So thank you for attention.
Could the other people please step up, and can you divide your